Hello friends, welcome to Gentleman Cadet Academy. From today onwards, I am starting a new series that will be related to the basic knowledge about the Indian Armed Forces. And this series is going to be very crucial for you from your SSB point of view, because if you know in detail about the armed forces, then your chances of selection increases. So the very first video will going to be regarding the combat arms of the Indian Army. And along with this, we are also going to cover the combat supporting arms of the Indian Army. So without wasting any time, let us start. Firstly, we should know the meaning of combat arms. Combat arms, these are basically the troops that carry out actual operations during the war. Now see, what are the types of combat arms? First is the Armored Corps. The main role of the Armored Corps is to deliver firepower with speed at desired place, that is to cause shock effect to the enemy. And these are the elements that are the first one to cross the international boundary. And over the years, they had played a crucial role, and they have been actively involved in 1965 and 1971 Indo-Pak War. And they engage enemy using the main battle tanks. And the main battle tanks held with Indian Army today are T-72, T-90 and MBT Arjun. And the example of the regiments include 16th Cavalry, 7th Cavalry, 9 Deccan Horse, 17 Puna Horse and 20 Lancers. And the second one is Mechanized Infantry. Mechanized Infantry is known as the youngest regiment of the Indian Army, and it was founded after 1965 war, as the need was felt that infantry cannot match up with the Armored Corps during war. And on the other side, the bigger tanks that are held with the Armored Corps, they cannot carry out the amphibious operations effectively, and they engage enemy using the lighter tanks that are known as BMPs, that is Bovia Mekhona Peshoti, which is a Russian word which means infantry fighting vehicle, and they can carry a section of soldier also. So these play a very important role, and they are deployed in plain sectors and as well as in high altitude. The example of regiments include the 48th Mechanized Infantry Regiment, 49th Mechanized Infantry Regiment and 21st Mechanized Infantry Regiment. The third one is infantry. Infantry provides boots on the ground, that is, these are the soldiers on the foot, and they fight hand-to-hand combat with the enemy, and it is also known as the backbone of the army. They are actively involved in CI operations in Jammu and Kashmir and as well as in northeastern part of India. The weapon system held with infantry include rifles and light machine guns, rocket launchers, grenades and mortars. The examples of regiments include Punjab Regiment, Sikh Regiment and Gurkha Regiment. On to the combat support elements. The first one is the Regiment of Artillery. Artillery is known as God of War, and they engage enemy from a very long distance. The main role of the artillery is to provide covering fire to the moving elements, and they engage enemy using howitzers, Bofors, mortars, and on the other side, there are some sections of artillery, that is the rocket unit, field artillery, medium unit and surveillance and target acquisition, that is SATA, that uses drones, UAVs and observation systems, that is radars and LORAS. The examples of artillery include T-20 SATA, 121-24 SATA, then it's 237 medium regiment, 112 field regiment and 21 rocket regiment. The next one is Air Defense Artillery, also known as AD. The main role is to guard sensitive locations like headquarters, communication centers from the enemy air attacks, and it integrates with the Air Force to prevent enemy air interference during battle with its highly sensitive radars and long-range self-propelled gun. The next is the Corps of Engineers. They provide engineering support in terms of laying minefield, constructing bridges and defenses, that is bunkers, and establishing water points during the operation. Once its engineering tasks are over, it is required to hold defenses like infantry and fight enemy. The Corps of Engineers, they has type of equipment like dozers, tractors, earth mover and various type of mine detector machines. Next comes the Corps of Signals. The role of the Corps of Signal is to establish an integrated communication and intelligence network system between the headquarters and the troops fighting on the ground. It provides reliable wireless and line communication and to ensure its serviceability during peacetime and as well as operations. The last but not the least, the Army Aviation Corps, also known as the Aviators. They provide the supporting role to the moving elements on the ground, and they are actively involved in various operations like Siachen and in northeastern parts of India. And at present, the Indian Air Force, they flies attack helicopters and they are administered by Air Force, but they are directly under the operational command of the Indian Army. And so this is about the Army Aviation Corps and about the combat arms of the Indian Army. And in the next video, I will be coming up the services of the Indian Army. So stay tuned. And if you like my work, you can tell me in the comments. And in the future, I will be coming up more such type of videos and as well as videos on the basis of your recommendations. And share this video with your friends so that they can also get benefit from this. And they can gain the wide amount of knowledge in a very short span of time. Please remember, the biggest quality of a leader is the selfless quality. Jai Hind.